Okay, so we have now the new topic, that is projection of solids. So I'll write here solids. So we have to study the projection of solids after plotting your views of projection of planes, in which we have studied that how to draw the projection of planes when the object is resting on HP or VP. In the same manner, we have another category of object for which we have to draw its projection, is your projection of solids. So basic is, we have different categories of solids that I'll show you in the form of PPT also, but just to give you an idea that you have your pyramid, you have your prism, you have your cone, and you have your cylinder. So these are the basic categories of your solids: prism, cone, pyramid, and cylinder. I'll show the objects in the real form, whatever models I have with me, so that you can have an idea that what are the different types of the solids. Now, in case of your planes, we have studied that you have certain thickness, like your laminar sheet, maybe pentagonal sheet, hexagonal sheet, you have your triangular sheet, then you have your circle or semicircular sheet or disc, what you call. But in case of solid, you have a fixed object having some different parts. So concept is same, that is, the object is resting on HP on one of its corners or edge. Similarly, here the object will be resting on its surface. So in solid we have the surface, but I'll draw here just one solid, that how to name its different part, that again I'll show you in the form of PPT. So this part is known as your apex. This is edge. This is again edge. This is your base. And now we have something known as the axis, that is the line which divides the solid into two equal halves, so that when we split it, it is something like this. So this is your axis. So this is basically, the object is your pyramid. Similarly, we have another category of object, that is your prism. In prism, the front view will be different. In case of your pyramid, you have your front view as your triangle. So front view will be in the form of a triangle. When we talk about prism, prism will be something like this. It will be in the form of a rectangle. Or say, let us say, so here you have the top surface, you have the lower surface or the bottom surface. Here you don't have the apex, but you have the axis, that is the line which divides the object into two equal halves. So you have the axis, and this is top surface, and this is lower or bottom surface. Now I'll show you in the form of the physical objects. Suppose let us take the case of your pyramid. So pyramid is something like that. It has a triangular front view. So front view will be in the form of triangle, such that you have one edge, you have another edge known as your slant edge, and this is a point where these two edges meet. So this point is known as your apex. If I draw like this, so this is your apex. This point is your apex. This point is apex. So this is one side, this is another side, this is the base. Now depending upon the type of base, you have the pyramid. Suppose you have a square base here, so it will be a square pyramid. If I have a triangular base, we will have a triangular pyramid. If I have a pentagonal base, I have a pentagonal pyramid. If I have the hexagonal base, I have the hexagonal pyramid. So, the main thing in pyramid is that you have the front view. So front view will always be in the form of a triangle. So it is something like this. It has an axis. So the most important thing to note in the case of pyramid, any pyramid, is it has an apex, yes, this point. Then axis which will be the line which divides this pyramid into two equal halves. So starting from this top point, that is apex, to the center of the base, this line is known as your axis. So axis will always be drawn like this, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot. Now coming to the another category of the, and this is the base. So base is here, in case here we have the square base, you can have any base. But if the base is circle, then it will be called cone. So cone is something like this. This is cone. This is apex. Dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot. This is center. So this is your cone. It means again, it will be sort of your pyramid, but base will be circular. So when the base is circular, it will be a cone, just like your ice cream cone or your birthday caps which we use, or funnel we can have. So that is your cone. So this is another solid. Now coming to the next category of solid, that is your prism. So how the prism is? When your object is such that its top surface and lower surface or bottom surface are same. Suppose here you have the top surface as hexagon, here also hexagon. So both its top surface and bottom surface are same, you have the hexagon. So this is known as your hexagonal prism, such that your front view is a rectangle representing its side or edge. This is the base. So here also the base is hexagon. Here also the base is hexagon. Similarly, we can have another prism known as your pentagonal prism. So here your base is top surface as well as bottom surface. These are your pentagon. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 sided figure, pentagon. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now naming all object, you can name in any manner. Suppose top surface is A, B, C, D, E. Bottom will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If it is pentagonal prism. If it is hexagonal prism, A, B, C, D, F is top and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is the bottom. If it is triangular prism, 1, 2, 3 or A, B, C. So pentagon, this prism also you can have pentagon, triangle, square, hexagonal. But when the top surface and the bottom surface is circle, then we term it as your cylinder. So cylinder is something like this. So this is bottom surface, this is top surface, bottom or lower surface. Now whether you have any axis in case of prism, yes, from the center, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, dash. So you have your axis in case of your prism, you have axis in case of your pyramid, but you don't have this apex in case of your prism. But certainly in case of your pyramid or cone, you have the apex. So this is the terminology that we use. So the terminology is your apex, axis, edge, base, top surface, bottom surface, top surface, bottom surface, axis. So this is how the solids are to be studied. So I just wanted to give you the idea that how the object will be. Again, I'll take up this case in which you have your pentagonal prism. So always remember that the prism is object in which the top surface and the bottom surface are having the same profile, are having the same shape. If pentagonal prism, pentagon, pentagon. Hexagonal prism, hexagon, hexagon. Triangle prism, triangle, triangle. If circle is the top surface and bottom is the top surface, then it is no longer prism, it will be termed as your cylinder. So So this is your cylinder. This is your cylinder. In the same manner, you have your pyramid. I'll take up the pyramid again. Pyramid, you have the apex, then the center line. Means if I divide this base and I connect it to the top surface or top point, this will be your apex. So the line joining the apex to the base is your axis, and then you have your slant edge. Now depending upon the base of the pyramid, you have your square pyramid, you have triangular pyramid, you have pentagonal pyramid, you have hexagonal pyramid. But when the base is a circle, it becomes your cone. Axis is there, apex is there, slant edge is there, but not the, what is not there? It is the apex which is not there in your prism. So there are two basic categories of solid. One is your prism, another is pyramid. Pyramid means triangle. Whenever triangle is there, you have the apex, the pinnacle, the top. So that is your apex. So apex is always available in case of your cone and pyramid. Similarly, you have your prism and cylinder. When the top surface and bottom surface are circle, it becomes your cylinder. Otherwise, all other objects are your prisms. So triangular prism, pentagonal prism, square prism, hexagonal prism. So all these objects are again regular polygon. Now another important thing is height of axis. Height of axis is very important in case of your solids. So height of axis will be given to you. So just on the basis of your different positions of the solid, that is whether the object is resting on HP or BP, or whether the cylinder is lying on HP or cylinder is lying on BP, or cone is resting on HP or cone is resting on BP, and accordingly how the one of its side is inclined. In the similar way, what we have done in your projection of planes, your projection of solids are there. Now another important aspect in case of your solid is the concept of your continuous and hidden. So there is one logic that suppose this is your XY line. Whether you plot the object in BP or in HP, one thing you have to remember that the points which are nearer to XY, they will always be hidden, and the point which are far away from XY, they will always be continuous, and the outer periphery of any object will be always be continuous. It will always be continuous. So when I take up the problem, I'll tell you. But suppose we have your this object and the object is resting like this. Then if we talk in terms of the points 1, 2, 3 and 4. No. If you are looking from top, whether 3 and 4 are visible? No. Why? Because they are nearer to XY. But what about this 1 and 2? Yes, they are visible. But since it is solid object, so all these points with respect to 1, 2, 3, 4, they will be continuous. But internally, they may be hidden. So the points which are nearer to XY, they will always be hidden. So every hidden object or every hidden side is represented by dash, 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 dash. There is a difference between this line and there is a difference between dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot, dash dot. This represents your axis line and this represents your hidden. So three types of lines are there: axis, hidden, and another is your continuous. So continuous means the outer periphery or the boundary will always be continuous. So these are the things which we have to remember in case of your projection of solids. Problems I'll take up as and when we discuss the cases. So I stop here with this basic introduction. Thank you.